only to the lost sheep of Israel. The woman came and knelt down before him. Lord, help me, she said. And he replied, it is not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs. Those who are without covenant, those who were not in a position to receive from God at that point, because Jesus came to his own first. And then through Jesus' death and resurrection, then the Gentiles were able to be brought in. That would be us. That would be those who were not covenant Jews, who were not in a place to receive from the Lord. So this lady, faith, touched Jesus. She got her blessing for her before time. So yes, it is, she cried to the Lord when he said that it is not right to take the children's bread and toss it to their dogs. She admitted, you're right, Lord. You're right. You're right, she said. You're right. Yes, Lord. And then she went on to say, even the dogs eat crumbs that fall from their master's table. And then Jesus said to her, woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted, and your daughter and her daughter was healed at that very moment. So glory to God. Being able to see who you really are, because the Lord Jesus said to repent, recognize. And he also said, those who humble themselves under his mighty hand will be exalted in time. Those who recognize that they are not righteous on their own, when they recognize that they are sinners, when they recognize they fall short of the glory, all fall short of the glory of God. No one is righteous. No one is righteous except the Lord God himself. And we receive the grace from God to be considered the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So in order for us to receive from the Lord, we have to repent. And we have to recognize our need for the Lord. A lot of people do not even recognize their need for the Lord. Those who are in self-righteous religions and such, those who believe that they have to do a certain amount of works and then they can receive from God. But when you recognize that no one is righteous on their own, and you believe and you receive that Jesus Christ is the only one, God who manifests in the flesh, the only one who was without sin, who never sinned, and his blood has cleansed us from sin. God said there is no forgiveness of sin unless it be through the blood. The blood makes clean. So Jesus' blood makes us clean before God. And it's not of our works that we can boast. Let's continue with the word of God here. Glory to God. Glory to God. God's word is true. God's word is so true. Listen to this. Okay, humility. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Okay? The Lord God, he mocks the proud. He mocks proud mockers, but he gives grace to the humble. The fear of the Lord is the instruction. The fear of the Lord is the instruction of wisdom. And before honor is humility. So in order for us to receive from the Lord, we must receive his righteousness. We must recognize our need for him. We must recognize that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We must recognize that. Repentance means accepting Jesus Christ. And then God gave instructions for us to be baptized. Being baptized, when you go down in the water, you receive your crucifixion. You identify with the death of Jesus. You receive that Jesus paid the price for your sin. You recognize that Jesus is Lord. You recognize him crucified. When you go down in the water, him crucified, you also receive his birth, his death. And then when you come up out of the water, then you're raising Christ in you. We're accepting Christ's life inside of us. Now we're hidden in Christ, and now it's no longer us, but now we're one with Christ, for Christ to live through us. That is why a public baptism is also mentioned. But then when we look at the thief on the cross, he didn't have time to go run and get baptized. So recognizing Jesus Christ as Lord on the cross as the Son of God, God said that he would be with him in paradise in heaven. So therefore, we accept Jesus' righteousness. We accept now that we have Christ living on the inside of us. That is repentance. That's recognizing and turning from our wicked ways, knowing that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, now being joined to the Lord. The word of God says, he that is joined to the Lord becomes one with him. Recognize one with his mind, one with his body, one with his mind, the mind of Christ, one with his body, the body of Christ, one with his spirit, baptized with the Holy Ghost. You receive also Acts chapter 2, that they were all in one accord praying, and then the Holy Ghost came in and baptized them all. So receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit, now it's no longer you that, so to speak, it's no longer you, and now you recognize that it is Christ. So if you can recognize, okay, I asked my daughter, I said, who do you identify with that? Who do you identify with that dog? Back to the example of the dog being groomed. Who do you see? Who do you identify with at that point? Do you identify with the groomer? Or do you identify with the dog? And she's like, Mom, you being all deep with this. I see a dog being groomed. So, okay, I get it. But I wanted her to go deeper. If I want to look at this from a spiritual sense, being that we just read the scripture and Jesus called this woman clearly a dog, okay, a dog. He called this woman a dog, pretty much. So you need to recognize, who do you recognize with it that? I identify with the dog. I identify with the dog, and I see the groomer. I identify the groomer as God when he comes and he is pouring in his Holy Spirit, and he is purging us from all wickedness, and he is renewing our mind. The dog is growling at the Lord. Be real, be real. If you sitting up there, oh, I got it all together. No, you're not identifying with the dog. But if you identify with, Lord, I need help. Lord, I need deliverance. Lord, I need you to renew my mind. Lord, I need you to fill me up. Lord, I need your touch to constrain me. Lord, I need you. Okay, so I identify with the dog. Okay. Okay, I identify with the dog, and I see God as the groomer. I see God pouring in his Holy Spirit. I see God purging my conscience from dead works. I see God quickening me with the power of the Holy Ghost. I see God. Okay, bless the Lord. That is how you identify, and then you see yourself as needing God and not the one being all together, like you all together. And then through Christ, you can see yourself all together in his loveliness. Bless the Lord. So that is what this devotion is about, for us to not be walking in deception. You know, God says, he who says he's without sin, that person is deceived. We have to recognize that it is Christ. He is our righteousness. It is God who takes away all of our sins. So then when we see ourselves as one who has repented of our sins, and now we have received Christ as our righteousness, now is God working in us to will and to do his good pleasure. Now we have the right mindset. We have a humble mindset to know that all of this righteousness comes from the Lord, and then we don't have time to be looking down our nose at someone else. That's why God says, forgive them, be quick to forgive. Why? Because I've forgiven you. So extend forgiveness to them because I have forgiven you. And you see yourself. It's not that you want to go around calling yourself bish. You know, I'm not gonna say the word, I'm just trying to say. You don't want to go around calling yourself that or calling others that, but truthfully, that's what a female dog is. Truthfully, when we are not deceived, we can see ourselves as we truly are, and then we can receive from him, and now we can receive that. Now I am the righteousness of God. Now I am his child. Now I am holy and without a fault or blame in him because of his righteousness. You see that? Okay, but before, you can't come to God all like, oh, I got it all together. Oh, I have no need of nothing. You know, I'm all holy in this, and I'm righteous. I ain't never drunk. I ain't never smoked. I ain't never done none of those things. I ain't never fornicated. I ain't never done any of that. You just see yourself like that. Okay, great. But look at this. How about your thoughts? God says, even if you look at a woman with lust, you have sinned in your mind. Okay, so now, so tell me, so can you say honestly you have never sinned in your mind? Okay, let's get real before the Lord. Let's be transparent before him. Let's recognize our need for him. Let us see him as our righteousness. Let us see him as our holiness. Let us see him as the grace. Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. Oh, bless the Lord. If we can just understand the grace of God and that he is our righteousness. And when he says that we're creating his image, oh yeah, we're creating his image. We're created in his image by being, having the spirit of Christ, glory to God, having that measure of grace that he's given to each and every one. But it does not mean that that is from us. That means that is a gift from God, lest any man should boast. And now you go from faith to faith, faith to faith, to glory to glory. When you receive Jesus Christ, you receive the blood of Jesus, you receive the forgiveness of your sin. When you receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you receive that now it's God coming upon you, the Holy Spirit coming on you, falling upon you, and being living his life through you, being joined to the word of God, that word that's in you that has become flesh, glory to God. Now you're being quickened by the power of the Holy Ghost. So therefore, we don't have time to turn our nose up at people. And we can see that we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Now, is that an excuse to go about just living out any kind of way? No, because some people try to use that for a pass to live, you know, any old kind of way. And you have to make that clear. No, that is a pass for you to see, Lord, I receive grace today, new mercies every day. I receive your grace to walk in the Holy Spirit, not to fulfill the lust of my flesh. Glory to God. I receive your grace today, Lord, for my flesh as it is according to the flesh to be crucified daily, picking up my cross to walk after your righteousness every day. Glory to God. So that is what this lesson is about today. So moving on to this last scripture. If we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in our heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whoever believes on him will not be put to shame. So glory to God. God loves you with an everlasting love. God loves you with an everlasting love. With an everlasting love. Now, after all of that, and you receive Jesus as your righteousness, you receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now you're going into the Word every single day to have your mind renewed. You're being discipled by the power of the Holy Spirit. You're being discipled by the Holy Spirit upon and in those who God has assign you, whatever church or you that you fellowship with, and God bless you, have your time with the Lord every single day. Yeah, okay, great. So you're being discipled now, you're walking in the righteousness of God. But don't go back after you receive all this liberty to start saying, looking at yourself as the one, I'm doing this. You know, I don't lie. I don't do these things. I don't sin. Don't look at it as you again, because now you're like frustrating the grace of God. Look at it like I have received the grace of God. Christ on the inside of me keeps me, and I walk in his Holy Spirit, which never sins. You get that? So now you're holding on to his righteousness, and you're still receiving that is him working through you to will and to do his good pleasure. And that way you're able to give him all the glory. Glory to God. So bless the Lord. I hope this lesson has been a blessing to you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your grace. We thank you that you have made us clean. We thank you that you poured in your Holy Spirit, Lord God. We thank you that you have purged our conscience from dead works and an evil, unbelieving heart. Lord God, we thank you for pouring in your grace in our heart. We thank you for quickening us with the power of the Holy Spirit. We thank you for cleansing us with your precious blood. We thank you for the indwelling of your Holy Spirit. Thank you for the fullness of the Godhead that's in Christ, that's inside of us. Thank you for your Holy Spirit upon us, Lord God. Thank you for living in us. Thank you that we are one with your spirit, one with your body. And God, we thank you, one with your mind of Christ, Lord God. So it is your righteousness that we yield to. And we thank you for this place of liberty. And we thank you for the humility gift so that we can receive your grace. We admit our weakness so that we can receive your grace, your abundance of grace to us, Lord God. Thank you for making all grace abound towards us, that we always have whatever the need be to walk in the Spirit, whatever the need be to be sufficient in Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. So blessings to you. Have a great and awesome day. Jesus is Lord, and Jesus loves you with an everlasting love. Be blessed.